The priestly and the prophetic blessing. The priestly and what? Numbers chapter 6, verse 32. Are you there? Are you blessed at all? Are you blessed at all? If you are blessed, can you give the Lord a big shout of praise? Numbers. Are you there, please? Numbers chapter 22, verse 27. Okay. Let's read the Malachi. Malachi chapter 6, verse 6. Chapter 1, verse 6. Malachi chapter 1, verse 6. Are you there? Yes, can you read for me?
A son honoreth his father.
And a servant his master. A servant his master.
If I'm your father.
Oh my God, where is my honor?
If I be a master.
Where is my fear?
Says the Lord.
Unto you.
My God.
Who are priests?
You.
Am I saying something here?
Now look.
Hear this. I want something here. There are blessings you cannot get until you meet the right man. Did you get what I said? There are blessings you can never get until what? You meet the right man. Who is the right man? Servant of God. Am I saying something here? Servant of God. There are people God sent to you. There are people God sent to your life. Until you meet them, you will never meet your destiny. Am I saying something here? That is why when you follow them well, you live well. When you serve them with all your heart, men will serve you. There are people, even when they are working, they say, Pastor, you don't see me. This person is not seeing me. This one will do it out of wickedness. You don't do something for God, for Pastor. The work you render it to God. Man said something to you. If you come to church because Pastor did not pray for you, and you get offended, you left the church because Pastor is not calling your phone, that means you were never a Christian. You were never a Christian. Two Christians, they don't get offended because Pastor don't call them your phone. Pastor don't leave their house. And I told Pastor to do something for me. He never answered me. He never responded. You were never born again. You were never born again. You ask yourself a question. This pastor I'm disturbing like this, and everybody is disturbing. How many times have I been a blessing to him? This man has been praying for me since I know him. How many times have I taken my phone, sent the recharge card to this man? Do you know when you collect, you don't give? It cannot be going. If you are only at the side of taking, very soon you will dry. Even as you are taking, God is blessing you. It turn out to become the cause. Common wisdom be mind that any man that God said to your life, you should be a blessing to the man. When he minister physical things, spiritual things to you, you go and minister physical carnal things to him. Your pastor don't need to tell you I'm hungry. You should know that after a man of God finish preaching like this, you need to take wine. You need to take juice. Have you ever walked to my office and said, Pastor, life is concerned? Your life has been a blessing to me. This shirt, I'm giving it to you. Okay, man? Since I've been this means I've been preaching here. I won't see anybody like that. I'm telling you the truth here today. Nobody! Say, Pastor, you have been a blessing to me. I want to bless you. I sat down one day and was asking myself, I said, how can people be in the midst of water? Dread and cover, soaked by the water, blessed! They don't recognize where they are blessed. Amen. Hallelujah. That is why if you are following a man of God, follow him well. Don't have anything reserved. Follow him well with all your heart. Your man of God might be, you might be older than him. When it comes to ministry, when it comes to leadership, God leading someone, God sent someone to you, has nothing to do with age. It is about age. David would have become the king of Israel. It's not age. Destiny is not about age. Am I saying something? It's about divine appointment. When God appoints you, brother, you become a head over anything anywhere you go. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, the question I asked, I said, how do I assess? This is the question you need to ask yourself. How do I assess the priestly prophetic blessing? How do I assess them? How do I assess them? That means, how do I receive them? How do I get them into my life? Number one, A, you must believe in this person. What I said?